हेलो एवरीवन, आई साकेत वर्मा वेलकम यू ऑल इन अवर न्यू चैनल दैट इज गेट अकेडमी ग्लोबल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक दैट यू लव्ड एंड सपोर्टेड अस इन अवर ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग चैनल दैट इज गेट अकेडमी एंड गेट अकेडमी प्लस. द आइडिया बिहाइंड दिस चैनल इज टू फैसिलिटेट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स इन द फील्ड ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग लाइक इलेक्ट्रिकल, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, मैकेनिकल एंड सिविल. वी वॉन्ट टू डिलीवर अवर बेस्ट कंटेंट in this channel so that every students can be benefited by our content. The language will be 100% English in this channel so that everybody can understand and take advantage of our content. As you know that we provided our lectures in Gate Academy and Gate Academy Plus were completely in Hindi, but many times we got the comments like the content should be provided in English. So we thought that we should start a new channel, that is Gate Academy Global, in which we will deliver all the lectures in English so that every students can be benefited. So it is not like the Hindi medium students or the students those are comfortable in Hindi will not take advantage of this channel. Everybody can take advantage of this channel because we are going to deliver the lecture in very simple and lucid manner so that the all kind of students, those who understand English and Hindi as well, can take advantage of this channel because the language will be very simple in this channel. And you know that the GATE exam is very important exam for our Indian students, those are doing engineering, because we are getting the jobs through it in our government sectors, and also we are taking admissions in IITs to do M.Tech and PhD. So through that we will get very good job in private sectors like multinational companies. So that's why the GATE exam is very important. But the GATE exam is not only important for Indian students, they are also important for the students those are living outside the India, because there are many universities who are taking the admissions through this GATE exam. Since 2 years, GATE Academy has been helping students in many different ways. Free video lectures has been provided in various topics of different subjects. And we have already provided you the GATE previous year solutions of very important questions so that you can get the good command over those topic. And GATE Academy has been already provided the chance of earning through that channel, and we have already helped students by providing daily practice question in our community post. We have provided a GATE previous year solution book, which is presently best book in the market, and we have provided good test series for you guys. So all these things will be happening in our GATE Academy Global channel also, with the new excitement and with the new features. So you will all enjoy here in this channel, and I am going to deliver the contents from those two subjects like communication and EMT. So the topics which I have covered in GATE Academy channel, the same topic I am not going to repeat here, and I am going to provide you a new series of lectures, that is from communication and EMT. Students always consider these two subjects very tough, but I can assure you that if you will follow me and what I am going to deliver, if you are understanding this very clearly, then you are going to get good confidence over these two subjects. So I will be discussing preparation strategy for these two subjects apart from my lectures, which book you should follow, and how to use the test series in these two subjects. I will be discussing all the things throughout the year till your exam. So let's start how to start with the communication system. Communication system, we will divide it into three parts. First is analog communication, second is random variable and random process, and third is digital communication. So let's see which part we will going to cover in analog communication. So analog communication having three chapters. First one is amplitude modulation. In amplitude modulation, we are going to cover AM expression, amplitude modulated signal expression, DSB-SC, double sideband suppressed carrier generation and detection, SSB-SC, its generation and detection, and we are going to cover the bandwidth requirement in these three type of modulation and the power requirement in these three type of modulation, and also the power saving in these two type of modulation. So in amplitude modulation chapter, we will cover these three topics: generation, detection, power requirement, bandwidth requirement. Time domain representation you can also see, and complex envelope, phasor diagram, all these things will be covered in this chapter. Second one will be angle modulation. Angle modulation is divided into two parts, that is phase modulation and frequency modulation, which we call FM and PM. And in this chapter, we are going to cover the generation and detection part of frequency modulation, the bandwidth requirement in case of FM and PM, the power requirement in case of FM and PM, the standard expression for FM and PM, how we can relate FM with PM. These all things will be covered in this chapter. And the third part, which we will cover in analog communication, is TRF, which is called tuned radio frequency receiver and super heterodyne receiver. These two type of receiver will be covered in this chapter, and the characteristics parameter required to analysis or required to design any receiver, which we will cover in this particular chapter. And in all these three chapters, we will cover all the previous year GATE exam questions and the important questions which have been asked in different exams. So this is part of analog communication. Now, we have random variables and random process. In random variable, we are going to cover different type of random variable, some kind of special random variable, and function required to analyze any random variable. And they are CDF and PDF, which is called cumulative distribution function and probability density function. These two functions are required to analyze any random variable. Then the characteristics parameter of random variable. Characteristics parameter of random variable like mean, moment, and variance. These things we will cover in this particular topic, characteristics parameter of random variable, mean, moment, and variance. Then we will discuss some special random variables. Special random variables. In special random variables, we will derive mean, mean square value and variance of all kind of special random variables, and CDF and PDF for it. Then we will discuss central limit theorem. Transformation of random variable. In transformation of random variable, suppose you are passing any random signal through half wave rectifier, or you are passing through it any square device, then the output random variable will be different from input random variable. It means that you are transforming this input random variable into another random variable. So how we can transform this random variable, and what will be the probability density function or CDF For those output random variable, we will discuss under this topic. Then we will discuss random process. In random process, we will especially discuss wide sense stationary process and autocorrelation function and power spectral density. These things will be covered in random process, and all the previous year exams will be covered in this particular chapter. So this is random variable and random process and analog communication. We will also discuss random binary process, but that will be the in the end of digital communication, because we have good idea about this random variable after reading this chapter. Now we will discuss digital communication, and in digital we will have binary values. So after that we will discuss this binary random process, and that will be your last topic, digital communication. So in digital communication we can divide it into again four chapters. First chapter is baseband transmission. In baseband transmission, we transmit the signal without modulation. It means that we transmit our signal directly through cable, that is our wired medium. The medium can be coaxial cable, that medium can be optical fiber. So in baseband transmission, we directly convert our analog signal into digital one and then transmit it through the wire. So in baseband transmission, we will discuss PCM, DPCM, delta modulation, and signal to quantization noise ratio for PCM and delta modulation, bit rate, inter symbol interference, Nyquist rate, Nyquist shaping. All these things will be covered in this particular chapter. Second chapter is bandpass transmission. In bandpass transmission, we transmit the signal after modulation. It means that the carrier is modulated by our digital data, that is our data sequence in ones and zeros form, and the carrier signal characteristics will be changing according to the digital data. And there are different type of modulation techniques like binary amplitude shift keying, binary phase shift keying, binary frequency shift keying, etc. These modulation techniques will be covered in this chapter. Its generation and detection part, its constellation diagram, its bandwidth requirement, its energy requirement, all will be covered in this chapter. Third will be noise in digital communication. In this chapter, we will cover noise analysis in these two transmission techniques. In baseband transmission, if the noise is introduced, how we can calculate probability of error or signal to noise ratio. In bandpass transmission, if the noise is considered, how we can calculate signal to noise ratio and probability of error at the receiver. That we will be discussing in this chapter. So in this chapter, we will discuss signal to noise ratio, matched filter, probability of error, etc. And the last chapter is information theory and coding. Information theory and coding, we will be discussing here about how much information contained in any bit, how we can measure the average information, information rate or channel capacity. So all will be covered in this channel. How we can detect error and correct it will be covered in this coding part. So first topic we will cover here is entropy. channel capacity linear block code and coding technique. So all these things will be covered in this chapter. So in this way you can start preparing your subject communication system. So first you should always start with analog communication, and if you are comfortable in signal and system, then it's good. And if you are not comfortable in that subject, then you should have basic idea about signals and systems, so that you can have better understanding in this communication subject. So always start from the analog communication, because that is very easy. And the amplitude modulation, angle modulation, and this super heterodyne receiver are having weightage in GATE exam. So you should prepare from there, so that you can at least get minimum one or two question marks in your exam. And then the random variable and random process, this chapter is also very important, and that is coming to the tougher side, because the question asked in this particular chapter is very tricky, and you should know about the signal very good in for particular this chapter. So in this way you prepare this subject, the sequence should be like this only, then you will get definitely good command over this subject. And the digital communication, this is the most toughest part of this subject. So you should start in this way. And the baseband transmission, the PCM, DPCM, and delta modulation is very easy part. And the Nyquist shaping and inter-symbol interference, which we GATE is more focusing about, so that is very tough, and that you should prepare very well. And bandpass transmission, the basic modulation technique you should know, and the generation detection and the power requirement or energy requirement or bandwidth requirement, at least you should know about this modulation technique. And the noise part, which is again very very tough in this particular chapter. So I will cover in this chapter very lucid manner, so that you can have better understanding and you can get the good command over this topic. And I'm sure that if you will follow me, then you are not going to face any difficulty solving this type of question asked in this particular topic. Thank you.